Hello. Hey, hi everyone. Are you? Can you all hear me?
Hi.
Okay, so let's start. So any question anyone would like to ask on the assignment? Any you want to ask or discuss or any other thing from the Power BI that we had yesterday?
Yes, Amit, I have a question. Like for the map of Brazil, do we have to pinch in for South America and accordingly it takes me to Brazil map, but how to, I mean, I can't enter Brazil itself. So is that the right way to do?
Couldn't get it. Can you download them, please?
I'll tell you the question number that you have given.
If you can share your screen, if you have built up something, I can help you with that.
Yes, I'll do that. So over here, if I pinch in, it takes me to Brazil. So is this the right way to depict this data? This is question number
See what
four.
is happening. See what is happening is if you see the map is correct. So the if you just take a look at it, just zoom in, just pinch it. No. Pinch in mode. I mean, yeah. So actually what is happening is otherwise, you know, there is one, if you see on the left hand side in Australia, there's a point. There is one location that is being coming over there.
Yes.
Over here. That is why, you know, what has happened is this map is coming little in a way that it looks that just the Brazil is not coming. So can you think of a reason why is this coming over here? Because if we have all the data of Brazil, so why is it that I see one dot over here in Australia?
I don't have any idea.
Sorry?
No, I don't. I can't think of any answer for this.
Yeah, that's in the data basically. If you take a look at the data, you hover on, if you hover on the dot, if you will hover on the dot, so it tells you the location, right? It is saying other state, other units of the federation, right? So other units of the federation, basically it's not any, it is not a location. So it's not a location exactly. If you say, so what they have done is, so like if I make a complete analysis of India, so I'm saying 20 visit per 20 visits, you know, came to Delhi, 30 visitors came, 30 visitors came to you know, Rajasthan, 20 visitors came to Bangalore, and 5 visitors to others. Now others I cannot plot on the map, correct? You can plate, you can, I can plot Delhi on the map, I can plot Bangalore on the map, I can plot, you know, the Rajasthan on the map, but I cannot plot, I can't plot others on the map. So that is the same issue that is happening over here. So there is this others that we have in the data, which is falling on this, and it has just randomly plotted anywhere. So what you do is, if you just, you know what, do one thing, just put a slicer over here, or maybe what you can do is in the filters, if you will come up, and you say that you don't want to show that others location itself on the chart. So that way, what will happen is this location will not come, and the complete Brazil will be visible. Okay.
Okay.
Right. So there were, I guess, four or five questions that we had. So
How do we do that? Let's
on the right side, you see filters.
Yes,
no, no, right side is a filter span. Just in the middle, that is closing between visuals and this. Yeah, open this.
Okay.
Okay. So in the state, you see, just click on the state arrow. And over here, and select all. Just do select all and uncheck that others over here. We will be finding this other configuration. Right? So now if you see, the Brazil is coming. Just okay. The Brazil.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes. Thank you.
Amit, how can we address the not available data? In some rows, there is data is not available. It's saying NA, the count of tourists is. So it's around 2,000 rows.
Mm-hmm.
So how can we address that data in the map?
I couldn't get it. Can you come again, please?
In the Excel sheet, we have data of around 2,000 rows, which the count is not available. It's not zero and it's not any number. It's simply NA.
Huh. So there are two ways. One you do is either replace that NA with zero, or you can do the data transformation in the Power BI also, which I will be telling you. That how we can transform that. We can do some transformation of data in the Power BI as well. Okay.
Okay.
So what we had done last yesterday, so what were the things we were discussing? I think we were discussing on the filters and using the card filters, right? So those were the things that we were discussing yesterday. Right, and we are seeing how to put up a title, logos and all those things, right? So what we'll do today is let's explore some more functionalities over here, right? So what we did was, like yesterday we had seen the filters over here, like these are the filters that you see, the slices that you can apply on the report. Now, you know, there is also a filter screen that I just want to discuss over here, and edit interactions, right? Interactions, I hope you all were clear on that, how that interactions work, interaction of the chart with one another. Okay. So what we're going to do now is basically, now, if you see, there is also one pane that is filters pane. Now, filters pane is basically in this, you will notice. Now, this is more like a backend filtering, right? This is more like a backend filtering. When I say backend filtering, see, when you click over here on the slicer, so what happens over here is the data gets filtered right away. I mean, it's like a user who is getting an option to make some selections and filter the data. And over here, if you will see, these are something like if you want from a backend, a filter to be applied. These are of three types basically. So you will find you have filters pane. Just a second. Thank you. So, you know, we have in the filters, we have three types of filters. One is filters, filter on the visual. We have filter on the page, and we have filter on all pages. So these are three types of filters that you will find over here. Right. So how do they work is basically, see, filter on the visual means you want to apply any specific filter that works only on that particular chart, right? So you see over here, when you select any chart over here, you will see these filters on the visuals will start coming up. So by default, whatever fields you have dragged in this, they will be coming up. But on top of that, if you feel that, you know, you want to add another filter on it, suppose you want to add a filter of region, you can just add region over here. And suppose in the region you select center. So what will happen is now for this particular chart, the data is only visible for region that is center. Other regions are not available, right? But only for this chart. If you want to show east and central both, you can select both of them. So both the two regions are visible. Right? So this is filters on the visual. So what you can do is you can apply, you can drag and drop as many fields. So if you feel that there's a particular chart, you want to show selective data. So you can do that from here. On top of that, if you remove it, and now if you just scroll down, you have two other areas, that is filters on this page and filter on all pages. Now filter on this page means if you drag any field over here, right? And I select, suppose any region, say central. So on the entire page, data will be visible only for center. Okay, so it makes it filters on this page. And you remove it from here and you see the last option, that is filter on all pages. So if you drag region over here and you select same thing over here, central as in over here. So if you will go on the second page also, there also you will see this filter is going to work. Suppose, you know, I drag the field of region. Just make any chart over here. So you see only central is coming, not the other regions. So that filter is going to work all across the pages. So depending upon what exactly, how you want to apply some filters, you can use this feature. Right? So just try it once. So you will see all these options over here. And in the filters page, when you select a chart, filters on the visual and otherwise filters on this page and on all pages. Deepa, I don't have any reference of this. It's just like we can discuss the questions over here, like if any particular question you want to discuss.
No, I was just asking, do you have any reference? Because for categorical data, we used to go for bar charts, and for time series, we used to go for line and this area. Yeah. And for the partition, whole partition, we go for pi. Other than this, I don't have any knowledge on other charts. So thought of asking you. So which particular...
No, we will be discussing. So okay, we'll be discussing the charts. But yeah, up till now, you have to just use those charts.
Okay. Amit, this Lysis is like page filters on this page, or
Slicer?
Yeah,
it's like a page filter. Yeah, so if you select something, so it works only on that page, so it is going to work only over here.
Okay.
So now, you know, we'll come to the page 2. So in the page 2, what we are going to do now is we are going to explore some other charts over there, right? So you will find a chart of like table. You have a chart of metrics. So if you click on table over here, right? If you click on this table chart. So what this table is going to help us with is that just a normal table, if you have to build up, right? Like for example, you have categories, you bring the category over here. You have subcategory, you bring the subcategory over here. And then you have sales, right? You want to show the sales. So a normal table, right? Like the Excel sheet that you have, you are trying to build something on the basis of that. So this is a table visual that you have, which you can use if you want to make the report. If you come in the formatting, you will find the options, a couple of options to format this as well, right? You have styling, you can change the style, right? Like styling is just like giving some effect, coloring kind of an effect to this table, right? Like this, change the style of the table. You have grid, right? So it will just show you some grids over here, right? So you get this lining that you see. Okay. So these lines, these grids, if you want, you can increase and decrease their thickness if you want. Just making it look like just so that they are visible. I mean, this is not the best practice, these colors that I'm using. You want to show horizontal grids also, you can do that. Right, so red color grids you will get. Right, so row padding as in this space you have that has been increased, right? This row padding. You have the option of totals also over here, right? If you will come down. Right, so you have the total of this the image or the option of totals. If you don't want to show it, you have an option as well to on it off. Right, you don't want to show the totals, you can turn it off. You want to show it, you can turn it on. Then you have the coloring options. Again, this is something very the same basic ones. There's an option of outline. Right, outline is just a line will come up on that totals. Right, so like if you see, I've just put up a frame, so it just put this. A little distinction on that. That's it. Right? You said top plus bottom, so lines are going to come in this. You have the option of conditional formatting as well, right? So you want to have some conditional formatting over here. So now see, conditional formatting is something, you know, you can have it, you can do it from these fields also. If you come over here on the fields, so see, it will make sense only if you do this conditional formatting now for these sales values. So right, if you click on this little arrow and you click on conditional formatting, you can give the background colors and all, right? If you want to give the background color, so you say background color and the similar, right, like we did in the Excel, similar stuff is going to happen over here. So you are saying that you want to format by color scale, and lowest value should come in the red color, and I am saying highest value should come in the green color. right? I keep the divergence on and I click on OK. You see the condition formatting has come up. Wherever the value is low, the total cell is low, it is coming in the red color, and as it is increasing, it is turning into green. I hope everyone is able to make it. Harshan, you were showing that report to me. You didn't make the second map, right? I think the visitors from which location we have the most visitors. I think you didn't get the map for that.
Yes, I did the other one. I'll show you. Just a second. Says you cannot share.
Okay, you are on page two.
This looks great. I'm not sure if it's right.
No. So see, why? What you've done is click on the map. So you should not put the count on the legend. Put the count on the size. Just hover down. Just remove this from that legend.
Okay, size.
Because color, it's not. So click on the size. So now you see, big bubble means higher count. Small bubble means smaller count.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right, so you can go into the formatting and you can increase the bubble size. Just a second, so if I just click on the count, the right count rate is correct. And then your...
This one is wrong, I know.
Count of month, what's...
Okay. I mean, I was just trying, I know that is not right. I mean, I was in that question only. So, okay. Yeah.
And now, can you show the page one once more?
Page one, yes.
The rest is fine. Okay. So do you notice any seasonality? So there were some questions also.
Yes, January is high, maybe because of the start of Christmas holidays that may be extended to January. Yes, January is high, it says. I mean, it's the maximum.
Apart from that, so just try to have an overall look. Anyone else also who would like to answer this?
Maybe the weather of Brazil is good in January.
Winter weather, in Europe.
I don't know.
The tourists are from Europe.
It's just a guess.
See, just don't focus on. See, what we do is we generally the mistake that you're making right now over here is you're just focusing on that highest point that you have, right? You are ignoring the rest of the months. So, basically, what happens is, although there was a question that I would have expected over here, the first basic question that comes is that the months that you see over here on the axis, they are not in a chronological order.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It's coming Jan, Feb, December, March, November, July, October.
Yes, because it's sorted in that manner, I think.
So basically what happens is that right now it is the months are coming not in the form of a date, they are coming in the form of character.
Mm-hmm.
Right, because the data is such. So that is why character data, it has sorted in the alphabetical order. But definitely I'll be teaching you a way as well that how you can sort this thing in, you know, the exact chronological order that it should come. Okay, so from that perspective, if you see that, you know, if you will try to see it over here right now.
Amit, sorry to interrupt, but I don't think it's sorted in the order of months. I mean, in the order of alphabetical order. It's not in that order. I think it's...
Sorry, it's in the descending order.
Descending order.
It's in the descending order of that, the count.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if you see over here, Jan, Feb, December. Right, if you will notice, if you want to see it in a better way, what you can actually do is this chart, but over there, you have the same problem. So if you see over here, this January, February. So if you focus on the December, right, then you have November, right? You will actually have to see a pattern over here. You will actually see the pattern is from upward to a downward trend. So there is a complete trend that you will notice, that how the count has been changing over a period of months and how we actually check the seasonality is, you will actually have to click on year 2006 on that first line. Just click on that year 2006. Click on the dot over there above the line. Yes.
So
did you click it?
Yeah, it's 50 lakh. This one, right? The count that is.
You have to click on it.
Okay.
Oh. Right. So, see, the data gets filtered out. Now, it is showing the data for 2006 only. So, seasonality is basically something that happens every year, right? So, technically, you should see the same curve every year, right? If suppose every year you see same curve, that means there's a seasonality that every year similar kind of pattern can be seen. But if with every year that curve is changing, that means there is no seasonality. People can come any point in time, they come anytime, they go anytime. If you see same thing, that means there is a seasonality.
Yes. Yes, so every time it's high in January. That's what the data says.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, this time it's June.
Okay, in the state, in the below map also, I think you have done the similar mistake. You have not put the count on the size.
Yeah.
So you just plotted the states, but you don't have any values on it. Like to which location more people have come up, to which location less people were. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so now
thank you.
Okay, so now similar to table, you have one more visual in this, that is a matrix, right? So if you click on matrix, so now matrix gives you a little more flexibility. That what happens in a matrix is you can decide what you want to keep in the rows and what you want to keep in the columns. Right, like in this, everything comes as a form of a column, right? Category, subcategory. But in a matrix, what is going to happen is, if I pick up this over here, right? I pick up the subcategory. And, by mistake, picked up the table only. This is a matrix. So you see, this is the matrix. So in the matrix, you get rows, columns, and values. So in the rows, I am keeping subcategories. In the columns, I am keeping region, right? And sales, I am keeping in the values. So this creates a proper this chart for me, right? This creates a matrix visual for me. So I can see it over here, that the sales are coming, rows and column wise, so I can compare it easily. It's like east region, south region, how much sale happened across the different subcategory now. Okay. I hope you are able to make it. Okay, so now, you know, if you come back to the page one, so now what I'm going to do is I'll show you one more feature of filtering the stuff that is called as drill through filter. Okay, drill through filter is like you click anywhere on this page, on this sheet, and from here you navigate to the page two, right? So what I mean by that is, like, for example, I am over here. I want that if I click on office supplies, right? If I click on office supplies, so on the page two, the data should get filtered only for that particular category, for that category that I have selected. So now that's another filter, another level of filter that you get, which is called as drill through filter. Okay, you're going to find this drill through filter over here. Okay, so how this drill through filter now works is, see, where the filtering has to happen? The filtering has to happen on the page two. So you have to come on the page two and you have to drag the category over here. You will pick up the category and put it over here. Okay. The moment you will drag that category, you will get a back button also. You will get a button over here. If you will click on this, control plus click, it takes you to the previous page. Now see, what's the benefit of this? Just have a look at it. If I right click on office supplies, you know, like even I'm not right clicking, it is showing me that in the tooltip also, that right click to drill through. So if you right click on this and you will find an option of drill through and you say page two, it is going to take you directly to the page two and where the data will be filtered for that particular category on all the charts, right? So filtration has happened over here. Now you only see the data of office supplies over here. Okay. I hope you are able to do it. Just try this one. Okay, are you able to do it? Hello? Okay. So over here, can you think of a way that if I, you know, when I filter this thing over here, if I right click over here, when I say drill through and I take to page two, so can you think of a way that what should happen is I should get the name of that particular category that I have selected that should come over here at the top so that it gets easier for me to understand at what data I'm looking at. Is there a way I can do that? Help anyone? So you know what we can do is we can actually place this card. Right? So if you put a card over here, and you put category name in this. See, this is showing furniture. Okay, it shows the first category. If I come over here on the page one, so if I right click on the office supplies and I say drill through, so I can take to page two. So this becomes office supplies. Right, so this way the data is getting kind of, it looks like the data is, you know, showing me the title, like what filter I have selected. Okay. So you guys can try this out. You know, the next chart that we're going to build over here is we can just add a new page on this, right? So what we will do is we'll talk now about scatter plot, right? So anyone who has an idea what a scatter plot is and why do we use a scatter plot? Right, so I think this is something we discuss in Excel also, like scatter plot chart. Yep. Anyone? Yep, Lakshmi, Naveen, Asha. What's the use of a scatterplot chart?
It's basically for two numeric values on both. When there are two numeric values that are plotted in a graph, then we use this.
See, you know, like basically this, the main idea, the main purpose behind scatterplot is
to check the linearity.
Correct, to check the relationship between the two variables. So if I create a small chart over here, right? So if I take a look at this, right? So you have year and some fiscal index, right? As the year is increasing, I can see the fiscal index is increasing, right? Similarly, if you take a look at some other chart over here, let's take, if you take a look at this, right? So I can see we have temperature and sales, right? So as the temperature is increasing, I can see the sales is increasing. So two numeric variables, you are right. And also the main, so that is what we plotted, plot that on it. And the thing that we basically focus on is that how those two variables are related to each other, right? Do you see some upward trend, downward trend, a downward trend, or a uniform trend, or you see no trend at all, right? So that is also something that we should focus at, apart from just creating a visual. So now over here, what we are going to do is I'm going to create a visual where we will build that how, where we are, where I'm going to build a chart where we will see that how. So we are going to build this chart on sales versus profit, right? How the sales and profit are related to each other. So when you pick this scatter plot, okay, so you will see details, legend, x-axis, y-axis, you know, you have size and play axis. There is a lot of stuff that you see on this. So I pick up the sales and I put that on the x-axis, right? So I pick up the sales and I put it on the x-axis and I pick up the profit and I put it on the y-axis. Okay. So when you make this chart, so default what happens is you get a single dot over here, right? You get a single dot. Why you get a single dot is because we know as a property of Power BI, when you use numeric fields, it aggregates it, right? So you get a sum of sales and profit over here, the total sales and the total profit, right? But this is exactly what I'm not looking at. I am actually looking at to see a relationship between sales and profit. So what you can do is when you drag your numeric fields on the x and y axis, and it's on the any other chart as well. When you click on the drop down, this arrow, you where you can change it to average, minimum, you can also have, you also have an option of don't summarize. So when you say don't summarize, now Power BI is not adding up this data. It is just showing each and every individual sales value on this chart. Similarly, I will say profit also don't summarize. So you will see each sales and profit plotted on this chart over here individually. Now this is how a scatter plot is created. Okay, so please, all of you first create this, then we'll move ahead.
No need to select, don't summarize on y-axis, profit.
Both have to do it.
Okay.
X and Y both. So what do you see over here? So if you analyze this chart, what insights do you get from this chart now? Guys, if you all will take a look at this chart, see my first observation from here will be, yes, I can see a trend over here, right, as a increasing trend, that if the sales are increasing, profit are increasing, right? That is quite obvious that this is something is bound to happen. If you will have more sales, you will have more profit. But another thing that takes my attention over here is that there are a lot of entries where I see a loss, right? You see profit is less than zero. Don't you think that this is a trouble over here, right? Basically, if my store is having some transactions in losses, so which is not a good point for me, I need to work on it that I don't get any transactions which give me loss, right? Because ultimate, the reason behind we do all these analysis is that it has to help the business so that they can take some strategic decisions based on that. So this is the same thing that I see or observe over here, that there are a lot of transactions that are happening which are giving you losses. So the company needs to take care of that part, correct? This is one thing. Now, if I come back to report, I mean, on this chart, what I'll do now is, you see at the top of the chart, you are getting this eye icon. This eye icon sometimes come on the top of your charts. It will come in that scenario, you know, when you have a lot of points. So basically, you know, there's a lot of overlapping of the data that is happening in this region. So it is just a warning sign of that, that, you know, you have a lot of data which is overlapping. So what you should do is you should use some filters in order to reduce down that data point, right? That is what this symbol is for. Okay. Then if you will come over here further, right? If you move further on this, if I'll show you something more on this chart now, is this is a very useful, I mean, this is very important chart, right? This scatter plot is something very important and gives you a lot of information. So on the X and Y axis, now change the numbers to sum, right? Change the calculation to sum, back to sum. So you will start getting one single number only. So you can see the total sales and the total profit, right? This is what you see now. Over here, if you just scroll it up in this scatter plot, you will find an option of details, right? You will find an option of details. Now, detail means like if you want to add additional details on the chart. Like for example, I want to see the analysis for different subcategories. So if I'll pick subcategory and put it on the detail, it is going to give me the sales and profit for each subcategory, right? So if you will hover on this, you will see that this is the sales and profit of storage. This is the sales and profit of, you know, whatever this is appliances, right? So this is how the sales and profit have broken up for the different subcategories. I hope you're getting this, right? So now again, right? And if you go come in the formatting, so you have a lot of stuff in this, right? Like for example, I'll change the shapes. In the shapes, let me increase the size. The bubble is too small to see right now. So if I show you this chart now, so what will be your insights on this? So, you know, because these are the kind of questions that will be asked when you go for the interviews, right? They will show you some charts and they will like to have your understanding that what do you observe from here. So that the reason that is, you know, I'm asking these questions as well, like what is your first point of observation that you see over here and you would like to share it.
Yep, anyone who would like to share some thoughts? Okay, so maybe I can ask you another question, like which is the best subcategory over there? According to you, which subcategory is the best performer?
Phones.
Phones, okay. Which one is phones? Okay. Anyone else? So because typically, see, what will be my expectation? I mean, expectation like what will I want from my business, right? I would like to have profit. Phones is definitely a good one. But if you take a look at this subcategory, right? Now, this is where the things are totally different. Profit is on the higher side, even with a lower sale, right? You see, on the x-axis, you have sales. So that means if you go on the right side, your sales are more. If you go up, your profit is more. Now, this particular subcategory is giving you the highest profit even with the half of the sales of phones, right? In a phone, you had a sale of 300K plus, then you got a profit of 40 to 50K. But over here, it is giving you 50 plus K of a profit with just half of the sales, right? So profit margin is the highest over here. And in terms of profit generation, also the profit is the highest. So typically this particular subcategory is the best one. Correct? If I take a look at this, let me just remove this drawings. So that is copiers, right? It's giving me a profit of 55K. And if I take a look on this, it gave me a profit of 44K. So we saw that, you know, we typically saw in the relationship, okay, it came on the top, but this is what we have as the best performer, right? If you see, there are a lot of subcategories which are actually giving me losses, right? Again, the similar situation we have, right? So if you see this, fastener is okay, still positive. But if you come over here down, right, this bookcases, and in fact, this one table is like the biggest loss making stuff for me, right? It has given me a loss of 17K, which is a big number, right? It is doing the worst in terms of performance. It is highest losses, I would say. Right, so this is how this chart is giving you so much of information in one go. Now, if you will come, you also have an option of legend. So what is legend? Legend means colors, right? So in fact, what I can do is I'll put category on the legend because every subcategory belongs to a category. So I can see that distribution, how the categories are distributed. So again, the question comes in, which category do you think is a good stuff, is doing good?
Technology,
right? So I can see over here that everywhere I can see the things are on the positive side. And in fact, if you come over here also, this machine is on the positive side, right? So I can see this. And if you come on this of furniture, so furniture, okay, it is mostly on the lower side if you see, right? If you see the big losses over here, right? Some losses over here. But whereas if you talk about office supplies, okay, the sales have not been that great, but still it is not a loss-making stuff for me. At least I'm making a profitable business with this. And you can also see the count as well, right? So like in the technology, you have just four subcategories. You have the highest number of subcategories. So you have bigger catalog, I would say, under office supplies. And you see a lot of bubbles of dark blue. So I can say, right, it is operating into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So they have different 8 subcategories that they have made. So there's a lot of stuff that you see. And now, you know, because on the page two, you had added that drill through filter. Now that drill through filter is working from here as well. If you hover on this, you right click on this. This was, you say drill through and take me to the page two. It is going to show the data of technology to you. Right, so it takes you over there and show you that technology and that accessories, that particular subcategory is also selected. So you see this over here. So that works on this page as well. Okay. So this is how you make a scatter plot now. And in the scatter plot, still there are two more options that you can see. One is size. So I can put quantity on the size. So size is again that same stuff that we were discussing in that map. Bigger the bubble, bigger the size, smaller the bubble, smaller the size. So let me, the size of bubbles is too big. Let me just reduce down that size. So you will see this chart now like this. If you see now, the bubbles over here. Okay, so we can take a look at it that bigger bubble means higher quantity. And if you see, in fact, in the copiers, you have very small bubble. That means even with the smaller count also, right, they were able to generate the highest of the profits. Please, I will just all make this chart. I'll just put back in 2 minutes, right?
help. I hope everyone is able to do it. Right. So shall I move forward?
Yeah, Amit, in that size access, mm-hmm. right? If I put profit, I can also easily analyze, right? For the scatter. Okay.
But I should not do it because profit I already have on the access. So okay. It will be just a repetition of that information. The same number that you see on the access, same will come on the size also.
Okay, if I want to divide further, if I want to have more insights, we have divided. Previously, we had only one. We have divided that into category and we have added some more fields in the size. So you are saying you should not repeat the fields.
Correct. Because it will be repetition. So for example, if I now come over here.
Because I found it very easy to find which is giving more profit if I add that profit field into the size. Previously, we used to go and check every category by using the tooltips, right? But
when the tooltip in the size also you will have to do it, right? You have to see the number, mm-hmm. put that number, right? So you will have to hover on that bubble only for that. So like this is excess. So by looking on this also, I can tell which has high profit, which has low profit. So I can say that this has lower profit, this has medium profit, this has a more higher profit, and this has the highest profit. As we go up, the profit is increasing, right? The same thing will come in the size as well. So if I pick up the size, a profit and put on the size. So if I just come over here, so you put this.
Because we were putting the quantity in the size, even though for some products, the quantity is less, but the profit is more. For some other products, the quantity is more and the profit is less. So I was thinking.
That is what I was explaining. So this is what I gave an example. That when you take a look at this bubble over here, although the quantity is less, but the profit is very high. I was able to have a look at it directly. See, I'm not saying you are wrong, but it is just that then you should interchange the stuff. So if you feel that you are more comfortable with profit, but that way what happens is we somewhere are going wrong in the rules of, you know, making the chart.
Okay. Sales and technically profit field should not repeat. That's what you're saying.
Sales and profit are, first of all, they are related to each other.
Okay.
Right. So, and if I bring this profit also over here. Okay. So you see that it's totally the same thing. If you will go, as you go up, you will notice the size of the bubble is increasing.
Yeah.
You notice it. Yeah. As we're going up, the bubble is increasing. So
yes.
The same thing comes over here.
Okay.
Now, you know, you also have one feature over here on this chart, that is play access. See, play access is just a feature that you will not be using in the report. It is just a fancy feature. So like what I do is on the play access, suppose if I put a region over here, if I put region in the play access, so what will happen is you will get a play button. So what this does is it's like an automatic filter. It will change the fields one by one. It will change the regions one by one, east, west, south, central, see. And it will look like the chart is animating, the chart is changing. See, let me play it. Right, so we have four regions only, so it is just changing the region one by one. And based on the data is filtering, and as the data filters, it looks like the chart is a dancing chart or an animation chart. If you have to build something for your website and all, you have to plot some report on your website, a good thing to keep over there, a person can hit on the play button and it will give an effect that the chart is, basically if you see over here, it also shows you a trend, right? Like for example, if you will click on this bubble, right, binders. So what it will do is it will show you the four bubbles. Like we have four regions. So it shows you four bubbles, right? You have, this is binders in central region, binders in south region, binders in east and west. So I can see over here, like binders gave me the highest, the sales and the highest profit in west region, and it was lowest in the central region. So it comes when you click on that bubble. Okay, so if I click on this bubble, it will show me the data of all the four regions, that how the sales and profit was in all the four different areas. In the west, again, I can see it is, so this is east, this is east, sorry, this is the one that I'm having, this is west, and this is central, and it would be north, the subsoil. So you can see all the four patterns, like it's like how the things were in the four regions. So you can see that by just clicking on that bubble. But otherwise, not a lot of use that you will see of this in your reports. Clear? Now, one last chart over here, right? So that we will create for today. That is histogram. Right. So now, what is a histogram? Histogram is a chart that we use for frequency distribution, right? Now, that is again a very important statistical chart that we have. So if I come over here on the histogram, right, this is how the chart looks like. So you can see you have bins at the bottom, that how many people you have in the age of 0 to 10, 11 to 20, 21 to 30, 31 to 40. So you can see all that information, right? So this is what you call it as a histogram. Okay, so it shows you count only. Right. So, for example, I want to make a chart. I would like to see that, you know, like how many transactions happen between 0 to 500, 500 to 1000, 1000 to 1500. Now, that is a chart that I want to create, because that will give me an idea that within what range people are doing most of their transactions. So what I'll do in that case is, suppose if I come up and I create for that, you know, what I will do is, first of all, I will have to make a bin. So that this range that you see, this is called as a bin. Okay, this range is called as a bin. That what is a bin size? Bin size is 10, right? If I'm saying I want to analyze the data between the range of, suppose, you know, I have the data of the students with me, with their ages lying between 10 to 100, right? So I want to see how many people do I have between 10 to 20, 21 to 30, right? 31 to 40. That way up till, you know, 100, I have the data with me. So you see there is an interval of 10. Right, I'm taking a gap of 10. That is called as bin size. That is called as bin size. So in this case, bin size is 10. Bin size is 10. And if I come over here, if I make the same intervals of 10 to 15, right, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, now the same thing becomes of, the intervals become of, intervals now are of, intervals are of, size 25, of size 5, bin size of 5. So that is called as bin size. So what we will have to do over here in the Power BI also, we will have to first create those bins. And how do I make that? So I have the table of, I have the field of sales. If I'll right click on sales and I will say new group, right? You will find the option of new group. So in this, it automatically creates, gives you an option of sales bins, that you are trying to make a bin. And what is the bin size? So Power BI is automatically suggesting that you should keep a bin size of 540. Because what Power BI did, it said that in the sales, you have a data lying between, minimum data is 0.4, maximum data is 22,000. So definitely I can't make a bin size of 10, right? 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. That will be too many bars, too many intervals that I'll get. So on based on that, Power BI suggesting me that I should keep a bin size of 540, which is definitely a little off. So what I can do is I'll change it to 500 only. I'll change it to 500 and I'll make a bin. Okay. So now when you make this bin, a new field will be created. You can see sales bins. You can see sales bins. Now what I'll do is I'll bring my bar chart. I'll bring my bar chart over here and I bring my sales bins on the axis. Okay, what do I want to see? I want to see the count. How can I see the count? Anyone who can tell me? So I have brought my axis over here. In the values, I want to see the count. How can I do it? Can I use order ID? Count the order IDs. How many order IDs if you have? So you see over here, I get the count of order ID. And there I go, there I see the chart. So I can see between 0 to 500, I have got the most of my transactions, right? 0 to 500. So now, you know, when you will hover on the sales bins, it will just show you the starting point of that bin. It will not show you that range. It will just show you the starting point. That is zero. If you come on the second bar, it says 500, that the second bar is starting from 500 to 1000. And if you come over here, it is 1000 to 1500. That is how these bins are created. So from here, from the distribution, I can see right away that the most number of transactions have happened between 0 to 500, then 500 to 1000, then 1000 to 1500. That is how this distribution is helping. Although this is not the ideal chart where I should be using this, because I have a very big variation that I see, right? Because 0 to 500 itself is taking 80% of my transactions. But still, as a property, we should be knowing it, that how this function works, how this chart works, because this is something that we will be using in number of instances. I hope I'm making sense to everyone. Okay, so now this is where we'll take a pause for today, right? So now what I'll do is I'll share a data set with you. So this is a data set that I'll be sharing with you, right? This UK bank customers. Okay, this is the data of UK bank customers. Now in this data, what you have is basically you have the data of customers with you, that you have some customer IDs, name of the customer, surname of the customer, you have the gender of the customer, whether the customer is male or a female, you have the age, what is the age of the customer, from which region of UK is he, what type of a job he is doing, white collar job, blue collar job, or others, when did he join the bank, and what is the current balance in his account, how much money does he has in his account. Now what you all have to do is you actually all have to use this data now and create a complete customer analysis report, right? Because these are customers' data. So now bank would like to know about their customers. So that I want to make a report for the bank so that, you know, we can know about their customers, because this will help them to come up with new offers and policies if they understand their customers better, right? So what you will do is you will create an analysis. I'm giving you some examples over here. And then you have to think at your end that how you can present them in the form of a report, right? Because see, the idea will be, so if a bank sees that I have more of young customers and more and less of senior customers, so bank will think that, you know, maybe my bank is not offering good, you know, the offers or some good schemes to the senior customers. We need to work on that. So if the bank sees we have more of male customers, maybe, and very less of female customers, they can think of, right, like, let's give an extra additional rate of interest to the females to attract more of them. So these are the kind of analysis that you have to think of. So I'll give you the examples. You have to create a chart to show total customers the bank has, right? Customer analysis by region, analysis by age. You can have analysis by balance, you can have analysis by job classification, right? You can have analysis by date joined. And by balance, gender, analysis by gender. So you also have to make sure that you give a proper formatting to it, right? You should have a proper logo of the bank. You should have a proper title of the report and the title of the chart as well. So you have to put all the things and you have to make this. Okay. So this is an activity that you can work, and definitely we can discuss on it tomorrow.
Amit, can you just show that notepad? You explained the bin size and interval, right? Just wanna see that.
Sure. Let me share this file. I don't know why I'm not able to. I'm facing challenge uploading the files over there on the classroom.
See, in the bar chart, right? If the count increases, my bar increases, okay. But the bin size is like static.
Ah, that will be sick. That is the interval. Nah? There's no same size only.
Yeah.
So it's like 10 to 20, 20 to 30. So that is just an interval. Okay, so that will not change.
You said it is used for frequency distribution. I'm just thinking how it is distributed.
So it is, see, yeah. frequency is count. So okay. This is the count that you see. That
yeah.
This is the
yeah. count that you count increases, I can increase. Yeah, there is a change in the bar length. Okay.
Right. So distribution is that across the different intervals, how that count is distributed. So I can see more number of transactions are in 0 to 500. And as the transaction amount is increasing, right, when we yes, come to yes. 500 to 1000, that is decreasing. So that is how they are distributed.
Here, the frequency is count of order, maybe.
Yes.
Okay. I got confused with the size and this. Okay, now I'm clear. Thank you so much.
Frequency means count. Frequency means count.
Here it is count. Okay.
I mean, the word frequency is count only. The meaning of that word frequency is count. So if you say count or frequency, it's the same thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you for the session.
Yeah, so I've shared this file, right? So I've also shared those analysis that you have to do. Right? So you can refer them. And on top of that, if you think there is some more you can add on to it, filters, slicers, drill through, feel free to use all those other things that we have done.
Okay.
We got office supply CSV. Is that correct? But you said UK bank.
Did I share the wrong for you? See this. Just a second. So I just shared that one also. Okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Anything you like to ask or discuss? And Lakshmi, were you able to sort that out? That issue that we were having yesterday in the SQL, the data flow.
Yes. Yeah. I can download the Excel and I can do the things.
Okay. Okay then. See you guys tomorrow.
Yeah. Bye.
Yeah,
right.
Thank you.
And I'll also upload that slides also, right? The PPTs I have, so I'll just upload those also and try if that classroom works. I think it's some issue with my drive space. My space has got over there, so I'll just clear that off and I'll upload the PPTs also. The property. So you can refer to them as well. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.